I would like to tell you about some theoretical background, PFC concept, how it is seen in Poland, how this concept as a whole. Then it will be a couple words about history, how this concept was developed in Poland. I would like to tell you about some characteristic concerning present model. I will tell you also about the role of the NIK in implementation of the public internal financial control system in Poland. And at the end, some information about our international cooperation. When we talk about PFC concept, I'd like to remind you, as a motto of my presentation, the old definition which was given by COSO committee in the early 90s. The COSO, yes, Committee of Sponsoring Organization of the Trade Rate Commission in the United States. Internal control, yes, it was defined as a process affected by an entity's board of directors, management, and other personnel, which is designed to provide reasonable assurance regarding the achievement of objectives in the following categories: effectiveness and efficiency of operations, reliability of financial reporting, compliance with applicable laws and regulations. According to these definitions, we can differ three pillars of PFC. This means financial management and control system, internal audit, and central harmonization unit, which is responsible for implementation of all of the system in public sector. Internal control. Could you go through? Yes, once more. Internal control. What is it? This is the system, organization, policies, and procedures that help to ensure that government programs achieve their intended results, that the resources used to deliver these programs are consistent with the stated aims and objectives of the organization concerned, and that programs are protected from being wasted, fraud, and mismanaged. In Poland, during the accession negotiation with the European Commission, our government was requested to regulate financial control in a uniform way according to internationally adapted standards and requirements. Of course, before the year 2000, before negotiation with the European Commission, some elements of internal control existed, of course, in our public sector. But I have to admit that these elements were relatively weak, and we didn't have any comprehensive system which would enhance management in public administration. And please, next time. As an answer for European Commission postulates, our government introduced such system, and it has taken place at the beginning of the year 2002, according to amendment on the Public Finance Act. The amendment, the parliamentary regulation, was based on the strategy paper. This means principles for introduction of the PFC system in the Polish public administration. Please, next. Some words about milestone in this implementation process. For instance, in March 2002, the Ministry of Finance established a special department, Financial Control and Internal Audit Coordination Department, which play played the role of central harmonization units. The next step was the appointment of the general internal auditor, who was responsible for implementation general internal audit in all our public administration entities. And additionally, in October 2002, Minister of Finance decided to establish the examination board, a special body who was responsible for qualification candidates for internal auditors. This system has been changed two times. The first bigger change, the first bigger change has taken place in the year 2006. This above mentioned institutions like general internal auditor and examination board has been abolished, but in the statute, in the act, were defined certificates which entitled candidates to fulfill the role of internal auditors in the public sector. For instance, accepted certificates like CAA or CGAP. They are internationally accepted also. And many of such certificates, and among of others, one of them was the completion of audit training program with the exam before special examination board appointed by the president of the NIC. Please, next. Present model of PFC in Poland is based on the newest act on public finance and is obliged since the beginning of 2010. General concept is, of course, based on the statute, but internal control has also different so-called soft regulations, like standards, like audit manual, the charter of internal audit in public finance, and many others. These solutions seems to be useful because, as you know, this is very difficult to make any changes, to make any improvements in the statute, in the parliamentary act. But it is much easier to introduce some changes in soft regulations, like standards, manuals, or guidelines. Please, next. The special role is playing by the Minister of Finance, which is responsible for providing support, managerial accountability, and is also responsible for tasks like assessing the internal audit, issuing guidelines, cooperating with domestic and foreign organizations. In the present model, the responsibility for ensuring an adequate, efficient, and effective management control has been assigned to the particular ministries and to the chairman of the local self-governmental administration. When I'm talking about present PFC model in Poland, I would like to add two elements. One of them is the principle of transparency. This means that more important documents of management control in Poland must be published in the public information bulletin. This is a special site on the website. Each body, each public body is obliged to has such a website, and these documents are available for public opinion. The second element, this is quite new also for us, this is so-called audit committees. In each ministry must be established such committee which is involved in strategic consultancy concerning internal audit and internal control. Please, next time. Such audit committee comprise the minimum 3 members. These are high rank officials. One is in the position of the secretary or undersecretary of state from the ministry, and others are from different governmental offices or agencies. For instance, tasks of the audit committee, indicating material weaknesses in the management control of the branch and proposing measures to improve them, setting priorities for annual and strategic internal audit plans, reviewing material results of internal audit activity and monitoring the implementation, and also many others. Please. What was the role of Supreme Audit Institution in Poland in development of PFC? I would like to point out three ways of contribution. One of them. Oh no! Please, next. Yes, this one. Yes. Three ways of contribution, of cooperation between NIK and governmental administration in implementation of PFC in Poland. First of all, was to give the opinion concerning projects of legal acts concerning financial control and internal audit. Our law department has given opinions about concerning this projects. The second way was cooperation with the Minister of Finance in preparation standards and guidelines for internal auditors. It was special agreement between President of the NIK and Minister of Finance signed in the year 2005. According to this agreement, was established special working group comprised of NIK's experts and governmental experts, and they prepared some standards, guidelines. One of the more important works was a glossary of terms concerning internal audit and financial control in our system. It was important because it provided uniform definitions for different terms and regulations. This glossary is still in use, I would say. And no. And the last way of our, I would say, cooperation is audit and control of the system in public sector. We can audit the public sector as a whole, or eventual different particular units. Please, next. Some general principles. Documentation which is created by internal auditors is available for us. our auditors and internal auditors should inform each other of any serious suspicions for bad management or fraud. And internal audit unit should ensure avoiding duplication of our audits. Please, next. Please let me skip some slides because I was informed that I have not so many time. And the next, please. According to last amendments in our regulation, we are entitled to including internal audit performance as one of our control audit tasks. Yes. I don't have so many time, but I would like to say some words about Article 12 in our Act. This regulation stated that different inspections, audit units in governmental administration and also in local self-governments shall cooperate with us and shall be required to provide the results of the audits conducted by them, conduct certain joint audits under the management of the NIC, and conduct ad hoc audits upon order of the NIC. Additionally, we have Article 12A, which entitled us to conduct joint audits with supreme audit institutions from other countries, together with European Court of Auditors. Our standards and methodology is based on legal regulations, of course, but we use also different auditing standards, guidelines, not only from INTOSAI, but also from International Federation of Accountants. And we have also quite long experience in auditing. One of our more important document is so-called Auditor's Manual, which has a framework concerning relations between NIC and internal audit. During the assessment of internal control system, we can assess such questions like legislation on public finance, organizational structure of the examined entity, internal regulations, workflow charts, accounting plans.